My name is Veronika Vassos. I was born and raised here in San Antonio. I have two children that are grown adults now. I am an educator in Northeast ISD, and I found PRMA through my oncologist. I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and it was an aggressive form of breast cancer, so I had to do some chemotherapy first for 16 treatments, and then I had my surgery. I had calcification in my breast tissue, and it was always hard to detect anything. The mammogram did not detect it. I even had the 3D mammogram. And it wasn't until, and I just had one too, and it wasn't until I felt the lump that, because I had to go back, I went to my doctor, I had to go back to the imaging place, and it still didn't show up on the mammogram. And they could feel it, so they did a sonogram. I had the deep flap procedure, and basically Dr. Garza had offered me several different options. But he thought the deep flap procedure would be the best because your body does not reject your own tissue, and I liked that idea. He highly recommended the deep flap procedure, and I'm glad I did because I wouldn't have wanted to go through expanders and that kind of stuff. This was all a more natural kind of way of doing it, using my own, because I got a two for one, basically. I got a tummy tuck and I got new breasts. So that was very appealing to me. Granted, the surgery is very long, but it is well worth it because once you heal, you almost, you're whole again. You're almost whole again. They get you up right away. You have to get up, and that was the hardest thing to do. And they make you walk laps around the area, so it was very difficult. But once you do it and you keep doing it every so many, you know, a couple of hours or so, it gets easier. But you have to push yourself. You have to get up, as hard as it is. When I got home, I didn't use the painkillers. I just toughed it out. So if you're not good with painkillers, you can do it without them because it hurts, but you can get through it. Tomorrow, it'll be a year. Oh my God. But go in with an optimistic attitude because I think my attitude is what helped me get through all of it. It's not always bad. If you get that diagnosis, it's not always bad. I remember getting it and it was horrifying to me. But the people you meet along the way, whether it's at the oncology office or whether it's at the plastic surgeon office, everyone is so supportive. And I think that optimistic and positive attitude is what gets you through most of it. I look back now and think, did that really happen to me? And it did, and I'm back to living my normal life. I'm just so glad chemo's over. I think I'd take the surgery over chemo any day.